Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to talk about GCC's stack usage analysis and the support that Compiler Explorer has for that built in. So if you do any kind of embedded development or anything else where you care about the actual stack usage in your program, you will want to stick around for this episode. Let's go ahead and create a very simple program here. I just have a main. Now, if you're not used to using Compiler Explorer, I want you to know that you can click down here on the output and you can see what errors or warnings are being generated. There's also a whole lot of tools and output windows and things that you can configure. Now, a relatively recent addition, I guess it's probably a couple of years now at this point, is this stack usage report, and this is part of GCC. I'm going to go ahead and turn that on. You can see that it's telling me right here that main is statically using 8 bytes. I believe that this only works with GCC. Let's go ahead and try Clang to double check. There, we're not getting any actual report back from Clang to speak of. Let's go ahead and play with adding a few things in here. Now, first of all, I'm going to add an array of 255 integers. You might be surprised to see that the stack usage does not go up. So let's go ahead and put this back in GCC. Now, I get this compile failure because I have warnings as errors and I have an unused array. Let's go ahead and utilize part of it. Now note that this says 8 bytes statically used in main. That might be surprising to you because I clearly have basically 1 kilobyte of stack space being used by this array of integers. Let's go ahead and increase this and have 1,024 integers. And we see that main is still using only 8 bytes. Now, if you were to look at the disassembly, you might observe here that main is just compiling to XOR, EIX, EIX, and RET. Let's go ahead and turn down our optimization down to 0. And now we can see what we would expect to see. We've got 4,112 bytes utilized in main on the stack. Basically, every compiler is going to completely remove this array with any level of optimization. Now, if we do something slightly more complicated, we can still see that we're only using 8 bytes of stack here. The compiler has basically optimized it all away for us. Maybe this isn't a very interesting example. Let's go ahead and do something where it can't optimize the thing away for us. There, now we are forcing these things to go into an array and we are passing that to the function calculate. Now here we can go, we can see 48 bytes are used. Let's go ahead and turn optimization on. And the compiler's not going to be able to fully optimize this away. We can see 32 bytes of data statically known is used in this function call. We can start to see something slightly more interesting where we can see that 32 bytes is used in the stack from main as it's calling through data, as it's calling through calculate. Okay, this is very simple. I just wanted you to know that this is a tool that exists in GCC, and this is a tool that you can use from Compiler Explorer. This is a flag that is listed under developer options in GCC, and it creates a file name with .su in the file name. Compiler Explorer is able to parse that output for us and put it into the window, which is really, really cool. And if you find this interesting, then you might also be interested to know that GCC has a -w stack usage warning that you can enable, where you can actually get a warning generated if stack usage will exceed a certain byte size. This could be really interesting if you are trying to make incredibly tight, tiny programs. Well, I hope you found this episode interesting and that you learned about something that you didn't know existed previously. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe.